My alarm clock went off at 6 o'clock this morning, as it does every Monday morning, even though I've got a day off work today. But if I'm going to get another video in this morning, I'll need to start as early as possible. So here we go. What we got? Number 72. Is a Sildon 13-3. Okay. 13-3. That's behind here, I think. Here it is. Okay, 13-3. This was like the 13-1, except it had an aluminium base and one or two other minor differences. This is actually a reproduction burner which doesn't have any wicks in, so I'll go and borrow one off the other Sildons. There we are. Right, oil up. This nice thick steam oil seems to be a bit thicker than usual this cold morning. Anyway. Thicker the better with steam oil, within reason. Off. Just. There it is picking up. Bit of priming by the sound of it. But not as bad as the cell before. As is quite often with these boilers with an overflow plug, they tend to put the plug bit too high. Or maybe it's something to do with the water in my area. But, I seem to have quite a lot of trouble with priming and very wet exhaust. It's settling down now. I don't know if you can see that, but it's getting flames licking out of the side of the firebox. So the burner's doing well. Nice smooth engine. A common feature of all the Sildan range is that they use very little steel at all. Most of it is non-ferrous, like in this case. The base is aluminium, firebox is aluminium, boiler and fittings are brass as usual, as is the burner and the cylinder. The flywheel is Mazak. Copper pipes. In fact, the only steel bit, I think, if I remember rightly, is the crankshaft itself. Well, it's got a brass disc crank. I and probably the trunnion is still as well. It generally is used as little steel as possible. And in this case, there's very little paint on it either. It's the flywheel is painted, and that's all. No paint on the base or the firebox or anything. Goes at a nice steady speed, very smoothly. No need to pin this one down. A bit noisy for some reason. I'm not sure why that is. Trying to tighten up the trunnion a little bit. We seem to be losing a lot of steam at the port face. Helps to have cast iron fingers in this game. Actually, I've just realised that steam is actually not coming from the port face. The exhaust port does actually come out this way, so that's where the steam's coming from. A little bit coming out from the front of the cylinder there, but nothing you can do about that. Just worn piston. Slowing down now, so hopefully that's the mess running out, not the water. Yeah. Things are going down. There we are.